Defense Updates has reached more than 150,000 subscribers. We're genuinely thankful to our viewers. You keep us going. We don't dilute your video watching experience in this channel with sponsored products. If you like what we're doing, kindly support us at Patreon. www.patreon.com/defenseupdates. The U.S. and South Korean militaries will join together for a final military exercise to close out a heated 2017, with F-22 stealth jets training right off North Korea's border. The exercise, called Vigilant Ace, will run from December 4th through the 8th and involve 12,000 military personnel between the U.S. and South Korea, as well as 230 aircraft, a defense official told the Wall Street Journal. It will also be the first time six F-22 Raptors will visit South Korea, and it will focus on enemy infiltration and precision airstrikes. The drill will close out a heated 2017 where President Donald Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong Un have exchanged vicious threats of destroying each other's countries. With the emphasis of stealth jets to the annual U.S.-South Korea exercises, this drill will be unlike any others. The U.S. typically invites international observers to its military drills, but North Korea simply has no way to track stealth jets. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why North Korea must fear the F-22 Raptor.
Number 5.
The Lockheed Martin F-22 Raptor is a fifth-generation, single-seat, twin-engine, all-weather stealth tactical fighter aircraft developed for the United States Air Force. The result of the USAF's Advanced Tactical Fighter Program, the aircraft was designed primarily as an air superiority fighter, but also has ground attack, electronic warfare, and signal intelligence capabilities. In 1981, the U.S. Air Force developed a requirement for an Advanced Tactical Fighter, ATF, as a new air superiority fighter to replace the F-15 Eagle and the F-16 Fighting Falcon. Codenamed Senior Sky, this program was influenced by the emerging worldwide threats, including development and proliferation of Soviet Su-27 Flanker and MiG-29 Fulcrum class fighter aircraft. The Request for Proposals, RFP, was issued in July of 1986, and two contractor teams, Lockheed Boeing, General Dynamics, and Northrop McDonnell Douglas, were selected on October 31, 1986, to undertake a 50-month demonstration phase, culminating in the flight test of two technology demonstrator prototypes, the YF-22 and the YF-23. After the flight test demonstration and validation of the prototypes, on the 23rd of April, 1991, Secretary of the United States Air Force, Donald Rice, announced the YF-22 as the winner of the ATF competition. It was later designated as the F-22 Raptor. The Raptor's combination of stealth and aerodynamic performance and situational awareness gives the aircraft unprecedented air combat capabilities.
Number 4.
The Raptor has a max speed of Mach 2.25 and also has the ability to supercruise at Mach 1.82. The F-22 is among only a few aircraft that can supercruise or sustain supersonic flight without using fuel-inefficient afterburners. It can intercept targets which subsonic aircraft would lack the speed to pursue, and an afterburner development aircraft would lack the fuel to reach. The Raptor's high operating altitude is also a significant tactical advantage over prior fighters. The use of internal weapons bays permits the aircraft to maintain comparatively higher performance over most other combat-configured fighters due to a lack of aerodynamic drag from external stores. The F-22 is highly maneuverable at both supersonic and subsonic speeds. Computerized flight control system and full authority digital engine control, FADEC, make the aircraft highly departure-resistant and controllable. The Raptor's relaxed stability and powerful thrust vectoring engines enable the aircraft to turn tightly and perform very high alpha angle of attack maneuvers such as Pugachev's Cobra.
Number 3.
The F-22 Raptor is built from the ground up for stealth and is designed in such a way that it has very small radar cross-section, RCS, of 0.0001 and is very hard to detect and even harder to engage. Only a few very advanced Russian radar may have the capability to detect it, though their effectiveness is not proven. The Raptor has three internal weapons bays, a large bay on the bottom of the fuselage, and two smaller bays on the sides of the fuselage, aft of the engine intakes. The main bay can accommodate six LAU-142A launchers for beyond visual range missiles, and each side bay has an LAU-141A launcher for short range missiles. Four of the launchers in the main bay can be replaced with two bomb racks that can each carry 1,000 pound, that's 450 kilogram, or four 250 pound, 110 kilogram bombs. The F-22 can also carry air-to-surface weapons, such as bombs with Joint Direct Attack Munition, JDAM, Guidance, and the Small Diameter Bomb. An internally mounted M61A2 Vulcan 20mm rotary cannon is embedded in the aircraft's right wing for close-quarter combat. While the F-22 typically carries weapons internally, the wings include four hardpoints, each rated to handle 5,000 pounds, that's 2,300 kilograms.
Number 2.
The F-22 is technically so advanced that it cannot be exported under American federal law to protect its stealth technology and other high-tech features. Customers for U.S. fighters are acquiring earlier designs such as the F-15 Eagle and F-16 Fighting Falcon, or the newer F-35 Lightning II, which contains technology from the F-22 but was designed to be cheaper, more flexible, and available for export in September 2006. Congress upheld the ban on foreign F-22 sales. Raptor, in simple terms, represents the best fighter jet the U.S. has.
Number 1.
The U.S. has 187 operational F-22 Raptors. These lead the airstrike in case of conflict and will be the tip of the spear. The overwhelming majority of Pyongyang's fighter jet arsenal is made up of 1950s and 1960s vintage machines, which even includes Chinese derivatives of very old fighters like the MiG-17 and the MiG-19. The MiG-29 is the Korean People's Army Air Force, KPAF, most modern fighter, and it operates approximately 40 of these. These are fourth-generation fighters, and their radars can't detect the F-22. Also, these are not equipped with modern air-to-air missile. North Korean mix of old Soviet-era surface-to-air missiles, SAMs, which includes the S-75, S-125, S-200, and the Kavadrat, are also incapable of shooting down the F-22. Basically, North Korea doesn't possess the technology to counter the F-22 Raptor. The Raptor will own the North Korean skies and will be unchallenged. It will take out important North Korean targets with ease. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.